I've always dreamed of that ultimate home theater setup experience, and today, well, we're almost there. This is the Hisense PX1 Pro. It's a 120-inch laser TV. It's kind of difficult to show on camera just how massive this 120-inch screen is, but just for context, here's my old 100-inch screen, and it almost looks kind of small in comparison. The image is about 8.5 feet wide and almost 5 feet tall. The image quality is top-notch, too. It's 4K HDR, 2200 lumens brightness. It kind of looks like a green screen image here on video. And every time our friends come over, they're just blown away with how massive and impressive the quality is. I'm Ben Schmincke from Authentech, and let me show you my favorite features of this whole setup and a couple of shortcomings you should know. Starting with the quick assembly, putting together this massive screen can take a couple hours, but instructions are decent. Plus, I love the labeled parts and pieces, helps to make it faster and easier. Plus, I found when you're assembling a 120-inch monster screen, it's not really a drag. It's kind of exciting watching it all come together. Now, the 5-second version here is you assemble the outer frame, roll out the Magic ALR screen, more on that in just a second, attach all the hook springs to stretch it out evenly and taut, then attach the final outer edge frame, and that's basically it. Well, my screen here is the 120-inch Hisense screen. Normally, you can't buy this one specifically with this projector, but my friends over at projectorscreen.com, they hooked us up with a custom link. They offer the similar 120-inch Spectra screen. Plus, they offer this little bundling discount. I'll give you my link down below to check it out. All right, so here's how cool this ambient light rejection screen is. Let's pretend this flashlight is the projector, the short throw, and it's shooting up and it hits the screen and then bounces out to our eyeballs in super bright and crisp picture. And then all of our ambient light sources, like lights from above, check that out. It's almost dimmed, it's super soft. Look at the comparison, super bright, dimmed, and almost gone. No reflections. That is pretty cool technology.
Basically, the ALR, or ambient light rejection screen, is pretty incredible and it works well. We have our TV set up in our living room and kitchen area, and with plenty of windows on each side, lots of overhead and rear cabinet lighting, you can't really see any of those reflections in the screen day or night. And normally with a projector room, you'd want to get it really dark, so this one works perfect for our setup. One detail you should note about this screen, after unboxing mine, it had this strong chemical smell that filled the room. I opened my windows and turned on the fans and it was gone the next day. Not a major deal, just be aware. Now let me show you the laser projector. It's called Ultra Short Throw, or UST, and the gist of it is that the laser shoots up this crisp and vibrant picture onto the screen, and it's placed just a short distance from underneath the screen. No more old school hanging from the ceiling back of the room projector. This PX1 Pro feels like top of the line with this trichroma laser engine. Basically, there's these three lasers, red, green, and blue, that give the HDR colors and that vibrant bright image. This projector also has a variable focus projector size from 90 up to 130 inches. It has Android TV built in, which is nice, a slightly smaller controller from last year's L5F model that I reviewed. While I love Android TV and I'm appreciative that it's built right in, sometimes it can feel a bit sluggish sometimes. So usually I end up going with my Chromecast with the Google TV plugged into that 4K 60 HDMI 2.1 port. Also built in the projector is a 30 watt Dolby Atmos sound, and it's decent if you don't have any other speakers available.
This is sounds coming from the built-in speakers. Here's a little audio from my old Bose soundbar. It's not bad.
But I think with most people wanting this home theater experience, you're gonna want an immersive surround sound. I'm excited to show you this audio setup I got from Sony. This is the Sony HTA5000 soundbar that specs 5.1.2 Dolby Atmos surround sound. Plus, we're pairing it with their wireless SW3 sub and their new RS5 wireless rear speakers with built-in batteries. And with their new firmware update, it features 360 spatial sound mapping for this crazy immersive audio experience. After setting up, you run this short audio calibration, which sounds cool and kind of trippy. They have microphones built in for this effortless measuring of distances and mapping out the space, thus it creates that intense 360 surround with virtual speakers. And after that, even though my rear speakers are probably not in the optimal positions, and we have this large open room layout, the 360 surround sound complements this home theater incredibly well. open our spaces, this sound system does an incredible job and very impressive with how full and crisp and loud it can get for both music and movies. It's immersive and just really brings that home theater experience to a whole new level. I love that the Sony soundbar works with many streaming options like Chromecast built in, Spotify, AirPlay, and many others. I like that little LED display on the bar itself. It's easy to know which input I'm on and such. I like that it has HDMI 2.1 pass through, so it even works with 8K or 4K 120 video. That SW3 sub, even though it's not huge in size, for 200 watt it packs a punch and still hits full and low sounds well. Those RS5 rear speakers are 90 watts each and they have wide direction of multiple speakers inside. Very rich sound and great clarity, and they're perfect for my flexible setup. I can AC power them with a nearby outlet or wall mount or go cable free with that internal rechargeable battery. They say lasts about 10 hours on battery life. It's an awesome sound system, plus it's expandable, so you could always start with just the soundbar, let's say, and then expand in time. So back to the TV, its colors are super vibrant, sharp looking image, and with a size like this, it feels so immersive wherever you're sitting as the viewing angles are really good. Since we have that open room concept, even when we're in the kitchen or dining table, the screen is plenty large and vivid to watch from afar. With movie tickets getting so expensive, and it seems like movies are more quickly releasing to online streaming platforms, I am all in for this home theater experience. I can pause it for snacks and drinks, share the experience with friends. It's like having a private theater to ourselves. Now, of course, no product is ever perfect, and here's just a few shortcomings that you should know. Firstly, as cool as ultra short throw laser projectors are, it can still be a difficult task of finding that perfect cabinet height that usually needs to be fairly low to the ground so your screen isn't too high towards the ceiling. Even ours is a bit higher than I'd like. Also funny how I didn't realize this at first, if you look at the marketing photos of a short throw projector, it's usually placed on a super low profile media cabinet, and now I understand why. Then that's just variable one. You also have to make sure the projector stands off the wall a fair distance as well. Projectorscreen.com, they actually have this really helpful measurement and placement guide. Select your screen size, like my 120 inch here, means the projector needs to be almost 17 inches off the wall, which can kind of stick into the living room space a bit. Another hiccup to note, when you buy a TV, you just pull it out of the box, plop it on a TV stand or wall mount, and that's basically it. With a USD projector, it can take some time to fine tune and level out the screen, level out the projector, nudging it in and out, left and right, trying to get that image placed just perfectly inside the frame. While the PX1 Pro still has that cool auto geometric correction, take a photo with your phone and it helps with alignment, I struggle to get mine to work sometimes. Plus my walls are so wavy and uneven, the screen doesn't even hang perfectly level, so that can mess things up just a hair. I think as long as you know what you're getting into on a setup and a system like this, once it's all said and done and then set up, then you're gonna love watching YouTube and TV and movies on this ultimate home theater setup. If you guys wanna see current pricing on the laser, the screen, or the surround sound system, I'll place my affiliate links down below, plus any discounts. Hope this video was helpful, and I'll see you subscribers in the next one.